this part, we'll try to classify bacteria on the basis of the arrangement of flagella, and we'll also see the structure of a flagella. So if we talk of bacteria with or without flagella, so if flagella are present, then they are called trichus, and if flagella are absent, then those bacteria would be called atrichus. So here, flagella are present or are found, and here flagella are absent. So this is how the difference is. If there are no flagella, then there is no further classification. But if flagella are present, then how and where those flagella are. So if a bacterium has only one flagella, then that would be called monotrichus. If a single flagellum is found at both the ends, then those would be called amphitrichus. If many flagella are found only at one end, then they are called cephalotrichus. And if there are clusters of flagella which are found at two ends, then they are called lophotrichus. And if flagella are found all around, that means if the flagella are all around the cell, then they are known as peritrichus. So, on the basis of distribution of flagella, these bacteria can be classified. And if flagella are absent, then there is no further classification. Now, what exactly is this flagellum made up of and what are the structure? So, if we are talking about the flagella, singular is flagellum, it has three parts. It has a basal body, then there is hook and a filament. And these three things make up the flagellum. The basal body, suppose we talk about the membrane of the bacteria or the wall, bacterial wall, which includes cell wall and the plasma membrane. The basal body remains embedded into this membrane. Basal body has rings. These rings are four in gram negative bacteria and two rings in gram positive. In our next videos, we'll be talking about the difference between gram positive and gram negative also. So there are rings. So say this is one ring, this is the second ring, and suppose we are drawing only two rings. So these rings, they are connected to a rod like structure. So these two structures which we have drawn, these are the rings, and this solid vertical structure, it is the rod to which these rings are attached. And together these things make the basal body. Now attached to this is a wider part, which is basically a connection between the basal body and the filament. This structure is the hook. And on the hook is attached a filament. The filament is tapering. That means the base is slightly wider and then it goes on becoming thinner. So this is the filament. Now this filament is made up of proteins, which are globular proteins, but they are arranged in a helical manner. And this protein is flagellin. So this is flagellin protein. So if we take a section of this flagellum, it is going to look like a solid rod-like structure. And when we talk about eukaryotic flagellum, we talk about 9 plus 2 arrangement. Because there are microtubules where 9 microtubules are arranged in a peripheral manner and 2 are in the center. Here, there is no such arrangement. It is just a solid rod of flagellin protein. And this flagellin protein, it is a globular protein. That means, if we are talking about, say, this filament part, the globulin proteins, that means they are circular. And these globulin proteins, they make chains, and these chains are arranged in a helical manner. That means they are arranged in this coil form of structure, and that makes the filament. It is a globular protein but arranged in a chain like structure. So this is how the flagellum is. Three parts: the basal body, which is in the membrane. So this complete structure is actually the basal body. And this membrane which we have drawn, this is the membrane. So basal body is embedded in the membrane. Hook is the connection between the basal body and the filament. And this is the structure which we find. And filament, or this flagellum structure, or the visible structure which is outside, that is many, many times longer than the cell. So normally what we do is we draw a cell and we draw a small flagellum. But flagellum is many times longer. It can be 100 times longer than the size of the cell. And this is how we distribute, or sorry, the classify all these bacteria on the basis of distribution of flagella. So single, two flagella at two ends, many at one end, clusters at two ends, and then peripheral distribution. So on the basis of presence or absence of flagella, we can classify these bacteria. Now in the next part, we'll talk about identifying these bacteria on the basis of gram staining. So we'll take up gram positive and gram negative.